Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming to share with you my latest journals I made. This is my design team project for amazing shop Dreamz, etc. I love this shop for a very long time, and I'm so happy to be designer for Jennifer now, and I'm also too scared that I will screw up. Hopefully not. And I made two journals in that kind of Midori style with my swapping. So I'm gonna share first this, my design team project, and then I'm gonna share with you this second one, which I finished. It's that Parisian which I made before. So I'm making few of them. I'm gonna share this a little bit later. This is journal which I made from amazing collection. This collection, oh my god, I don't know, widget, it's that word. I'm not sure if I pronounced that right, but. Those papers are amazing, they are gorgeous, and they are very, very versatile. Here is one sheet. I print out those tags. I have to put them all together, all those images. This is one sheet. So I print four sheets plus this banner from all those sheets. They are amazingly gorgeous. There is so many options you can use. You can fussy cut out those words, those beautiful butterflies. You can place them like tags. This collection, it's stunning and it's very versatile. I'm using it now for my different journal. I'm kind of in lilac color, and I'm making this type of journal. It's multi-opening with pockets, with so many pockets, and I'm using just pieces. I'm using for my layouts. Where is it? It's not finished yet, okay? So don't don't be so afraid. Here is one butterfly, here is that telegraph sign, here is journal, and I fussy cut out that journal with all those clocks. So I'm using it just here and there, and it's amazing. This one, it's from that collection as well. And it's gorgeous embellishment, and it's really easy to use, like this, memories. So you can use it totally many different styles. I'm gonna share with you what I made. It's multi-opening again, junk journal. It's fully loaded and it's really very heavy, but once you will take off all those ephemeras, you can use them in your journals. So once you will take them off, it's not too heavy and it's more manageable. But I really like how it looks, and I think this journal will be for sale, so I think it's, if someone will gonna spend money, they should get something for those money. So that's why I loaded this journal so much. I'm using this, not ribbon, what is it, elastic band for closure. Here, this one, it's not just charm or embellishment, it's also, I shouldn't take off that, that bandage, but it's also like carrying, you can hang it on your hand, and it's really strong, so it will hold all this journal together, so you can carry that like your handbag. And I used some embellishments on that elastic band as well. Here is a small pocket, so you can slide something behind. This is backside. Here is another pocket, and I used all those papers for decoration. There you can see that end of that page. This was like journal page. So I printed out. I used loads of glossy accent in this journal because those images are just gorgeous. So here is large pocket. And it's opening like this. I showed this journal a little bit in my previous video. So now we will go through all this stuff. I'm gonna start on this side. Hopefully I'm in view. I took few advices which Patty sent me. Thank you so much, Patty, for all your advices. I'm gonna try it if I will be successful. So here I made this multi-opening pocket, and I decorate all those pages with this amazing design. As you can see, it's really cheerful, it's gorgeous. Here is like pocket, and I use this acetate piece for decoration. I saw using this acetate piece in many videos about photography albums, and I really like that. It looks amazing, it's catching eyes, so I had to use it. And I actually, this acetate, it's piece of packaging.
I'm gonna try.
Yeah, I've got here a small piece. When you got, I don't know, butterflies or some stickers, maybe, I'm not sure. This is from those butterflies, this piece. This piece, it was probably from some stamps, not sure from which one. But I just cut out with my scissors this piece. And I place it to Tim Holtz die cut, what is it, dies. Those labels, those decorative labels. And I went through to my Big Shot, and it looks amazing. So if you've got those plastic packaging, you can use them like your decoration here. And I tried to stamp it with my permanent stamp, and it doesn't work. So next time, I know I have to use that hairspray. I made video a while ago, how I am printing on acetates. So first, I'm gonna spray it with my hairspray, let it dry, and then I'm gonna stamp it, because I know then it will hold together. So this is just small advice or small sharing. So here is pocket. Also, pocket is here. I showed you in that video how to make inserts. So large pocket is here. Here you can see that gorgeous, gorgeous images. So everything you can fussicate out. Here you've got that number strip. And it's continue. Yeah, this I just cut out. It's continue with beautiful images. Here is a page from journaling pages. All those birds. I'm planning to make some artistic journal. Totally different journal than I'm normally doing. And those birds and those butterflies will be brilliant for that. Those butterflies. And all those words. You don't have to Google for any special design. You've got everything here. And another small tip, those beautiful stones, those are clear stones. I'm not sure where I've got them. I think I lost it right now. Oh, mamma mia. I'm not sure where I placed that small drawer with so many goodies. I've got here a small drawer with so many goodies, and I can't find it now. So shame. Oh my god. No. I'm sorry, I can't find it. But I think you can imagine what I mean. Those are very small clear stones, so I glued them using that glossy accent, just a small bit of glossy accent. I glue it on book page, on dictionary book page, and then I fussicate out. And then I'm using it like my decoration. They look fabulous, and they are not heavy, so it's brilliant decoration for your tags, or for your pages, for your layouts. This journal, I glue it on a page with pink design, that lilac design, where I've got it, here. It was very soft lilac design, and I glue it on that soft lilac design, and I'm using it with that design, but with that book page underneath, it looks better. I like it more. But those clear stones are very useful and very decorative. So it's this page. Here is just space for journaling, and I'm keeping there this tag. Here I made large pocket, and it's there, this ephemera. I'm gonna try put all those ephemeras somewhere on the side, so you will see. Here is space for journaling. Here is another space for journaling. Beautiful papers, as you can see. And I printed on both sides, so all those images are from this gorgeous collection. And right now, Jennifer have a beautiful sale, gorgeous, wonderful sale. She put all papers from this collection, I mean tags, journaling pages, those ephemeras, I don't know all those words. But all that collection, it's in one pack for a really great price. You will have so many great, amazing digitals for a really brilliant price. I will put link for those down below. Here you can see. Look at this. Yeah, here is, I'm sorry. Here is another ephemera. It looks like this. So I'm gonna put all those here. Small Adore tag. All those ephemeras on on the side, and you will see those papers for writing. Here, small ephemera. And I used few those circle paper clips like decoration and holding those ephemeras. Here, another ephemera. Come on. Yeah, like this. There is really lots of space for journaling. Here is another paper from this collection. And again, I used this acetate piece. And as you can see, this is, I think, Tim Holtz cabinet card die. Hopefully I remember that right. Here is another gorgeous tag from this collection. And maybe I can show you. Yes. This is one page which you can print out. So on that page are those two tags with that Dream Big, and I just resize it and I put it on one sheet with all those others, and it's a really gorgeous collection. Here we've got another ephemera. I have to do it slowly. I used different coffee dyed papers, and this is from, I think, a recollection. Just because are there those birds as well and butterflies. Here, gorgeous collection. Here is that enchanted. Not sure. Oh my god. Sorry for my pronunciation. And here I made those small bits and pieces. You can add there just small notes. Here another tag, another ephemera. Here we've got second signature with those openings. And I forgot to say that tutorial for those triple pockets I found on Papercrafter 45 channel. I will put link for that video down below as well, so you can have a look on that video. So here is this page with this ephemera, and again small layout on that acetate piece. This is from that collection. This is from collection as well. Really gorgeous papers. Gorgeous papers. Here I'm using pieces of acetate with stamp like decoration. This one, this is from collection as well. And this, I will have another tip for you. Here, another ephemeras. This, I'm gonna show you my findings. I'm using sometimes that, what is it, molding, that it's not paste, maybe it's paste, what you can put to your molds, let it dry, and then you've got that resin piece mold, what is it? And I saved this one, it's from Christmas advent calendar with those small chocolates, and I'm gonna use it for my Christmas decorations, because there are beautiful, beautiful images. And when I worked with this, I noticed that here it's number, and I was, if I will put that paste here in that number, and I will wanna use it in my project, that's so shame that they are like put inside. So if I will flip it over, my numbers will be like in a mirror. And then I was thinking, why I will don't put that paste from the bottom? So they are not pop up from my mold. They are inside of my mold, but they look really good. So if you've got that paste which you put to your molds and it's dry on the air, use it. Go to check out your those plastic sheets or your molds or anything. Maybe you will find there some number as well. And it looks really good. I like it. So it's another sharing what I found. Here another beautiful, gorgeous papers from this collection. I love all those words which you can fussy cut out from there. Because sometimes I've got really problem to find nice words in a nice design. And here you've got everything. Sorry, I have to sip a little bit of water. Sorry. All those are for journaling, from journaling pages. Yeah, here is that opposite side, other side. Here I've got another pocket. Again, I use that acrylic stone, or what is it? And I used again acrylic piece, like my decoration. As you can see, that paper is gorgeous. This I fussy cut out from that sheet, from one sheet, and I just fold it. So half of that butterfly is here, another half is here. And I use that acetate on this side as well. So you've got pocket here. All those signs are from this gorgeous collection. And here I just decorate with those brings. And here in those pockets, we've got this tag, this ephemera, and another ephemera here. Also, those papers are from this collection. Here, this beautiful tag. Gorgeous, really gorgeous. I love that collection because it's very useful. And here I've got, those are proper vintage papers. They are from books I found on Carboot sale. They was very old books. So I use them here for journaling. Here is just a crazy pocket I made. So you can slide something behind. Gorgeous papers. And I didn't decorate them too much, because I think this journal is decorated really well. And here we've got those two tags. Gorgeous. Look at that beautiful picture and memories. You can use it for so many different projects. And here I forgot to put some tag, but I think it's okay. Here is large, really beautiful large pocket. And here I used again that glossy accent for those gorgeous butterflies. And here we've got double pocket. It's pocket on the top and pocket on the bottom. And I used loads of those metal pieces like decoration, just here and there. It's just small bit and it looks good. This I fussy cut out from those small tags I print out. And it's like small decoration on tag. We will go to other side. Here I place just a journaling page for some notes or for some addresses, phone numbers. here it's beautiful, gorgeous envelope, which is on... Envelopes are on a few sheets. Yes, I forgot, see? And it's opening like this. Here I've got small ephemera, and this can be open like this. So you've got pocket behind, that small space for journaling, and you've got this space for journaling. And this is from this gorgeous collection as well. Here another ephemera. And here you can see how gorgeous design Jennifer made with this collection. I really love that. And I'm using this small tag for my closing. And that flop from that envelope, I used like half of my pockets here. It's very large, beautiful pocket here. And I used, again, a piece of acetate. Again, it's that Tim Holtz, I think it's called cabinet card. It's that middle one, not that large, it's that middle one. And before I glue it here, I glue it on a piece of journaling page from this collection, and I really love that effect. And I decorated then with those, wooden pieces and those flowers. And here we've got again a few journaling pages. This is gorgeous paper, really, I love this collection. Oh yeah, sorry, here I've got Larchak. Again, I use this small stone with that book page background, this one. And here we've got in pocket, I made pocket out of glossine bag. It's pocket here. And small pocket or slight space, it's behind that glossine bag. And I made small layout using all those gorgeous images from that collection. So even if you will do a mixed media project, mixed media journaling page, here in this collection you've got loads of options of what you can use. Here I use just strips I've got, like my decoration for tuck, and I think it looks fabulous. It's just really two strips, and it looks good. I love that. Here I used a little bit of a glossy accent, but I didn't cover all those... spread your wings. All those wings, because when you look at a butterfly, he looks like his wings are like with those fluffy effect. Feathers! Oh my god! Like with teeny, mini, small feathers. So I wanna make that not slight effect. So I just went with that glossy accent, really, like I'm drawing with that, and it was dry with those lines. And I really like that. I really like that effect. And here, again, image from those collections. And behind that, I used piece of lace, so you can see behind that another butterfly from this collection. Again, a few pages. Oh my god, I forgot. See, mamma mia, I forgot. Here I made small pockets. Here are three pockets on this side, so you can slide something behind. They are large enough to hold business cards or bank card. And here I've got large pocket here with this tag. And small pocket here. Again, I used some sign from those beautiful papers. Here, just a few ephemeras. Again, journaling pages. I really love this collection. And you can use this collection for so many different styles of journals. For romantic, for grungy, all those kind of those images in that a little bit darker colors, they can be used in grungy style. And as you can see, if you will see all that collection, I was totally amazed how Jennifer can put all those collections, all those beautiful images together, and they match together really well. So here, I'm talking too much. Here it's like belly band, so you can slide something behind. And here I will have to repair that butterfly. Here is pocket which I showed you before with that small embossed effect. This is that extra. Added signature which you can all took off. Here I've got two ephemeras. I'm gonna show you if you will take it off. No, not took off, but take it off. If you will take it off all, and you will carry this, hold this maybe on your table or in your drawer somewhere, this journal will be very small. So here I've got that extra insert. Just made like pockets, and it's full of ephemeras as well. From this side, I've got envelope, opening envelope. Here are two pockets. And I left that window here so you can see a little bit what is inside. And I put there this ephemeras. In that second pocket, it's this ephemera. Those papers are not from this widget. Oh my god. I'm sorry, I can't say right that name of that collection, but I will definitely put the link for this collection down below. But those papers are not from this collection. Those papers I just add here because I love that collection. It's also from Dreamz, etc. and it's called Documented. I love this collection. I'm so surprised that I didn't finish project which I've got in one drawer over there. I just didn't finish that yet. But I love this collection as well. And here some small ephemeras. Here I used again piece of acetate. And it's just like stack spot. And here is another large pocket. And those ephemeras. This is like small booklet. Those ephemeras. And it's closing on magnet. When you open it, you've got pocket here with those ephemeras. Oops. Like this. And again, I use this gorgeous paper. I'm not sure if I made... No. I made just one pocket. Here I've got this beautiful image. And I'm not sure... Yeah, you can slide something small behind this piece of acetate, which I also glued on one of those sheets from this collection. It's like that butterfly. Here it's one wing. Wings. Here is one wing, here is body of that butterfly, it's continue in this side. So I used one sheet of that from this collection, like my background, for this one. And it's open like this. Did I... Oh my god, I didn't show you. Sorry. I'm gonna show you that rest. God. I thought that it's opening on that other side. Here is the rest from one side. Here I used again that piece of acetate. This is from this beautiful collection. This is from that Documented collection. And this is from this widget collection. I will have to have a look again. I will have to put it to Google Translate and tap there that speak now. The translator will tell me. And I've got here just this sign and those ephemeras. Sorry for that, I forgot. Here another side. And here small booklet. So it's here on this side. Sorry. Oops. Okay. And when we open it here, I've got large pocket here. And there is this ephemera with this one. And in this pocket, I've got just small notes. Oops. Did I stuck? I think I stuck there. And this small ephemera, it's here. And here in, and it can be open. I showed you in the previous video. It can be open and something can be slid in this pocket here. And same, it's on this side. It's just opening to this side. So it can be open here and it's pocket behind. Hey, come here. Yeah, it's pocket here. And when you close it, you've got pocket here from the top. And again, those beautiful papers. Here. And when I close this side, I will turn it and I showed you, I think, already this pocket. Yes, I did. And because those pages are decorated, I made, again, like a writing board. I used, yes, this is, I think I showed you somewhere where I showed you. Oh, here. Oh my god. Here. No. Here. This, it's same image like here. This gorgeous butterfly. Gorgeous. From that side, I use different image from those gorgeous papers. And I really like that effect with that acetate. So, and finish that sentence I already started. Some of those pages are really well decorated, like this one. And if I will want to write on some page here, I will have really difficulty to write down because those embellishments will make my pen just jumping all over it. So I made this small writing board. You can put it under your page and you can really easily write anything you want. So this is like small tool, because all those pages are really, not all, but so many pages, it's really decorated well. So this is small tool. And now I'm going to show you. So this is journal without embellishments. Here it's a pocket. Yeah, I showed you. This is journal without embellishments. And it still looks good. It doesn't look that it's empty at all. You can cover it like this. And here is that extra insert. And here are all ephemeras which are included in this journal. I think I will place them to separate back. So this is what is included in this gorgeous, not gorgeous, gorgeous journal. I mean what I made from this amazing, gorgeous collection. It's a very versatile collection. I really love that. I stopped to do anything else. I just start to work with this because it has really so many options what you can do with it. Mixed media project, your journals, it's so many options what you can do with this collection. I will put links for Jennifer Etsy shop, for Jennifer's blog down below, and definitely I will put links for this collection and for that documented, because that documented collection, it's amazing as well. And maybe if you will sneak out in her shop, maybe she've got those stones, and I think that this is brilliant embellishment. So this is my sharing with this journal. And now if you don't mind, I will very quickly, oh, this belongs to the journal, very quickly share that other one. This is smaller and it's not so loaded like that before, but it's loaded as well. And it's heavy as well. And this is cover of my journal. Again, I used that elastic band closing, and I decorated with those embellishments. Here I use like decoration this chain, silver chain, and it's open like this. This journal have a pocket here, has a pocket here with this bingo card, and it's open like this, and it's in that I'm gonna place it on the side. Oops, sorry. And it has that vintage style, like was those before, it was Parisian. Here, it's just editing, because I really like this, those cards. Those are self-adhesive cards, so you can put some images underneath. Oh my god, it's folding down. Just bear with me, I'm gonna move it a little bit more. Oops, la. Sorry for that. So I really like those, what is it? Business cards or business card holders. So I included here. And here I've got just very simple book tag. And I used different types of papers, and I coffee dyed them. And I used few images with those gorgeous ladies, like my decoration. I use that Parisian style of paper in this journal. And again, few ephemeras. I used some laces. Here is pocket. And when you slide something right behind, so you can see that through that window here. Hopefully I am in view. Am I? Hopefully, yes. I am still not sure if I am in view, because in my camera it looks like I've got a huge space, but when I put it to computer, it's like teeny, meeny, small space. So I'm not sure. Here those ephemeras. And I think this is from that Jennifer collection as well. I mix it, those ephemeras. So here papers for journaling. Here I made a layout for my pocket behind. It's pocket here. It looks like this from this side. And I include those, this gorgeous it's like postcard. And this gorgeous ephemera. And this journal will be for sale as well. Well, I think. I'm still waiting for answer from one lady. So if she will don't answer me, you will find this journal on my eBay as well. Here it is just envelope from book page, which I decorate from this side with this gorgeous picture of, oh my god, in my language, this city, it's Benátky, but in, I think it's Venezia, that city with the city in the water, with those canals. It's beautiful Italian city. And I include here this postcard and just index card, coffee dyed. Here I've got this ephemera, gorgeous. And it's envelope here. With this ephemera and again, coffee dyed insert card. Here is just small layout. Here I've got like a newspaper page, so you can read it. And I used few photography pages from very old book. It's a book from 1930, I think. And I really love those photographies, so I didn't decorate them too much. Some of them. And here I'm using a large bulb, like my holder, for this ephemera. Here I've got this small ephemera. And from that other side, it's this cabinet card. Here I've got another beautiful lady. They're really gorgeous. And here I've got just a small book page tag. And it was behind this tag spot. Here I've got small layout and it's like a belly band for your tags or for some notes. And here I used again acetate piece. Again, it's from that packaging. And this time I used embossing folder, so it has that embossed effect. And I made small layout. Here I'm just hanging this Utah. Is that Utah fabric? Utah heart. And I've got here this gorgeous image of lady. And here is pocket behind as well. Here I've got this small holder. It's, I think, business card holder. I don't know why I like to use those those pockets and holders. I think they are nice. Something exciting. And here small ephemera. Here I made a pocket in end of that book page. And it's just index card there. Again, a few pages for writing. And here I made belly band. And I used this gorgeous lady. I really like her. She's gorgeous. So I have to use this wooden frame around her. And I found this ephemera, this picture. And I was thinking it's that curly design. It's exactly what is matching all together. So I made like belly band with her. Oh, sorry. And this way. This beautiful ephemera and this gorgeous lady. Again, pages for writing. And here, just few ephemeras in this envelope. Not one ephemera and one index card. Small layout with Paris. It's Paris from 19, where when in Paris was the World Exposition. I love that age and I saw many French movies about that exposition. So hopefully after my holiday I will show you one journal in this style, which I really love. It's not finished yet and I don't want to show you right now because it's not finished yet. That journal have to be shown after I will finish that. And here I used stamp for this. It's that what I told you, that molding paste which dry. I've got it here. I'm using this paste. It's not paste, it's mold. What is it? Craft clay. Oh my god. Crafting clay. This is from Docraft. What is it? Memory clay. Tonic Studio. Here. Tonic Studio. Creative crafting clay. this dry on the air, and it's dry, it's like plastic. I'm not sure how to explain it, but I will show you on this frame. This is from same product, this is from same crafting clay, and it's movable, and it's really very, very light. It's like paper, and you can use any colors to decorate it. You can use any glue to glue it down. So I used same product for this one, and I just stamp in this paste, what is it, clay. I just stamped Tim Holtz inspired stamp and let it dry, and then I used my inks and I make it like a rusty effect. So this Tonic Studio Creative Crafting Clay. It looks like this. Here was the top. Really brilliant. Really brilliant tool. Or how we call it that. And yeah, sorry. I've got pocket behind. And this small ephemera. Again, few pages for journaling. And I used few of those paper doilies. And here I've got small layout using this beautiful picture from 90s from that World Exposition. And I used those, divider or folder divider, I think. And this beautiful ephemera, small ephemera. And again, few pages for journaling. And here I've got like small booklet where you can write down some notes, and it's pocket here behind. And again, a few pages, and here I made pockets using large piece of lace, and I included those ephemeras, this postcard, and this small postcard. And from that other side, I used like decoration, that CD cover, because it's a really brilliant decoration, I have to say. And it's pocket here from the top, and also it's pocket in that CD cover. It looks like this. Here is the end. I've got small slide pocket here. This is end of that chain, which is outside, like decoration from this one. So this is that other end here. And on this side, we've got small envelope here. I'm not sure if I placed something, I forgot to place something inside. But here I've got like belly band for my, this is small ephemera, this one. And here I've got mini teeny booklet. And I've got here what is it? So here small teeny mini booklet with small ephemeras. Picture. Teeny mini Eiffel Tower. Wait, come here. Oh my god, it glued inside. I have to unglue it. I will do it later. Here is opening. Small tag here. Here is like tag spot. It's really very small. Teeny mini journal. It looks like this, and I have to unglue that image. No. Here I've got like a small pocket, and those two ephemeras. Again, few pages for journaling. This is small insert, and this can be open. And we've got this ticket. Here can be placed some small photographies, and it will be brilliant. And I left this beautiful photography. Here I've got like extra space for journaling, maybe space for photography. Same is on other side. And I just use those vintage images. And here I use this gorgeous image of those Parisian ladies, and I make it like small booklet. And I use that, oh my god, it's knife in my paper trimmer, which not cut all that paper, it's just cut in pieces, so you can just rip it now in at the same same point. I hope you know what I mean. I don't know how to say that, how to explain it. It's like that ripping notebook. Oh my. I'm so glad I can talk with my hands. So then it's more understandable. Here, just those two ephemeras. And again, this nice paperclip. Few pages for journaling. Here I've got envelope. And I've got ephemeras inside. This one. And this one. And here I've got those beautiful butterflies. Oops. And it's holding with this gorgeous paperclip. And from that other side is this gorgeous lady. And here I try to make a pocket out of paper doily. But I'm not sure. I'm not sure if I will do it again because it's so soft, that pocket. It's really soft. So probably it was for first time. First and last time. Because it's very soft pocket now. But I tried. And here I've got pocket with this small layout, paper doily, envelope. Do I have something in? Yes, I've got here this picture. And here I've got this boy, beautiful cabinet card. And again, piece of photography. And here is a just small layout. It's just writing space. It's covered with those lovely couple. And this is end. Here is just small layout as well. This is end of this journal. Those are ephemeras in this journal. Ah, this I have to hang it back. Oh, it was open. Ephemeras in those journals, including that small mini booklet and those poles. And this one. So this is my sharing for today. Those flipping journals, multi-opening journals. I hope you like it. I really hope you will go to have a look on this gorgeous collection. Widget. Oh my god, I'm sorry. I don't remember right word for that collection, but I will definitely link this collection down below. Both of my journals will be probably on eBay. I will sort out my Etsy after I will come back from my holiday. I've got, I think, 2 or 3 more videos which will be uploaded, but they will go in the air when I will be already on my holiday. So I will look forward to see you back when I will come back from my holiday. Hopefully, I'm gonna meet Despina in Greece. Hopefully, we will meet there, girl. I can't wait. I'm so excited. So, if I will have some news, I will try to connect you through my Instagram. I will also try to upgrade some informations about me through the Instagram and also through the Facebook. Hopefully, you like it. Those journals will be on that eBay probably just till the Saturday, because Saturday is last day when I can send it. And I can't be sure that my sons will send it if something. So till Saturday they will be open to purchase, but not longer. Then it will be after my holiday. Thank you so very much for all your amazing comments. Thank you so very much for all your support. And hopefully see you soon after my holiday. Have a great time and take care, people. Bye.